Looking at the citadel, the first steps in learning how to read the landscape is, and I quote David Bowie, through sound and vision. Waiting for the gift of sound and vision. That's what he wrote when he was in rehab. And he was drifting into solitude, and that's, I don't want to compare myself to David Bowie, but it's something that is, oh, let's listen to the bells. Well, there's so much to see and hear. Just looking at this, just side of the citadel in this environment. But in this video, I also try to pick up some sound and let you listen to the birds sing. And what I call nature's wall of sound, and what the wall of sound is that I will explain later in this video. So watch and listen. Every morning I wake up early to the sound of bird singing. Singing is just an understatement. It starts about an hour before sunrise, and for about 2 hours they pull out all the stops. And as they compete for my attention, they mix in what I have started to call nature's wall of sound. The wall of sound is a music production formula developed by American producer Phil Spector in the 1960s. The intention was to use all the possibilities of studio recording to create an unusually dense orchestral aesthetic that would be better received on the radio. Spector explained in 1964, "I was looking for a sound so strong that if the material was not the greatest, the sound would carry the record. Now, listen to the birds again." Well, this side of the roof needs a lot of work. The paint has been eaten away by the smoke of the chimney, and of course also the sun doesn't help. Sanding, 2 coats of paint, and I have to extend the pipe of the chimney by at least 1.5 meters, and of course attach it to the roof. And the solar panels are going to be at the end, three solar panels in a row like that. That should do the job. But a lot of work. So let's get started. Thank you.
Thank you.
During my friend's conversation lesson with Michelle last Thursday, her husband Dominique, who is a passionate historian, told me that this path, along which the cabin is located, was used in the Middle Ages by the knights participating in the tournament at Chauvency le Chateau. It was held in 1284 to bring together the greatest knights of France and Germany for 6 days of jousting and other noble and sublime activities. Of the couple who have been kind enough to help me find my way in the French language, it is Dominique who has actually retranslated the poem by the 13th century troubadour Jacques Brutel, who was present at those festivities. And can you imagine? Knights in white satin on this very quiet path that leads from the citadel to Thonne-les-Près to Chauvency le Chateau, and that twice a day. My expectation was that the closer to nature, the slower everything would go, and the more harmonious the coexistence would be. But the opposite seems to be true. Even the animals and plants seem to be in a hurry. Whether it is because of the changing climate, or whether they are in a hurry anyway, because life is short. I wonder whether nature is driven by a Darwinian efficiency to improve quality and keep up a race with man and his technology. For millions of years, it was able to run at a leisurely pace, but now it is straining. Apparently nature is peaceful and at rest, but if you look closely at the grass along the path, it is also a jungle with a constant struggle for life and light. Again, Darwin prevails. Visually, it is and remains a spectacle with all shades of green. The birds that feed on it venture only to the top of this forest. If you lose your balance, especially in the morning, and get wet with dew, it's not easy to get away. Last night, the stone martin walked by. I was sitting in the doorway of the cabin. It was already too dark to take a picture. Half dark, I would say. And I wondered how the martin would describe it. I always thought it was a stone martin, but it climbed so easily up the trunk of this cherry tree. He or she must have noticed me, the smell of humans, or maybe it was the sound of the door, which I opened a bit more so that I could sit down more easily. And as quickly as the seasons succeed one another, so does the martin accept me into its domain, its habitat of silence and darkness. But clearly we both like cherries. I'll have more quotes for you in my next videos. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe. Thank you.